What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. I hope you are having an amazing day. And in today's video, I'm not only going to show you guys MIUI 10 running on MIA1, I'm also going to show you how you can install it on your MIA1. And I will make it as easy as possible. But if you don't still understand it, just leave it. Just use your stock Android 1. Because even though the developer has tried his best to make it as stable as possible, there are still some bugs over here and there and some just force closes, or there is a chance you might lose your data. So yeah, if you want to just test MIUI 10 for some weeks, you can of course do that. But I don't recommend it using as your daily driver. So let's just explore. So first of all, MIUI 10. Yes, finally. Now this is not the stock ROM from MIUI 10 or Mi 5X. This is actually a Epic ROM base, of course based on Mi 5X. Now why Epic ROM? Epic ROM's base is actually known for running good on non-MI devices, such as, for example, I've been using Epic ROM on my S7H back in the day on MIUI 8, or even on Euphoria running on Android Marshmallow MIUI 9, and it just works flawless without a MI ID. So again, if you have never purchased a Xiaomi Redmi phone and don't have an MI account, great, you don't need that in order to run MIUI on your MIA1. So that's again amazing. But still, if you want a stock feel, it's pretty stock. There are not a lot of obnoxious changes over here, such as, for example, there are more toggles over here, as you can see, but perfectly usable. It's a bit faster than your MIUI 10 in terms of animations too. So yeah, pretty great. Again, it's debloated, so as you can see, there are lesser cards over here. Again, only the necessary ones are over here, such as, for example, the Google app on the Play Store. If you want YouTube, Play Music, you can of course download them. And then again, it just works flawless. So for example, here are your apps, works pretty great, messages and stuff. And the only bugs over here are the notification LED works but doesn't work when you actually lock the phone. So yeah, that's pretty weird. Then again, if you go to the camera, as you can see, MIUI 10 camera, this is a pretty old build, like 8.7.12, so it doesn't have the front portrait mode. I hope developer surely updates this to Android Oreo with front portrait mode and stuff. But yeah, portrait mode surely works for the behind camera. Then again, 4K recording is working, but the HDR is broken. But then again, as it's based on Android Nougat, you can always install your favorite Gcam and it just works flawless. You can also follow my video over here, that again works. And then there is not a lot of to talk over here. It's just basically MIUI 10 base. So for example, if you have never seen the UI, here is your all new volume panel, the Android P style. Yeah, I love it. It's actually better than Android Pie. Then again, here is your newer recent apps panel. Works just great on MIUI 1. You can clear out the apps like that. Here is your new quick settings panel. Again, blur and stuff looks great. The security app again updated. Now the security tabs are not actually updated as this is an older build. But then again, just works great. You have Game Booster too, works just flawless. Now hopping into the settings, as you can see, my device, going over here, MIUI version. Now this is actually completely modded, so you can actually receive updates through here if the developer supports the OTA updates. So yeah, pretty easy and nice if you also want to just download the add-ons. Again, as you can see, only Magix is available, which is pre-installed. Then again, you have device name, model number, all specs, Android version 7.1 Nougat. Again, not bad at all, as MIUI just feels the same. But if you have some API related stuff on Android 8.1, just wait a bit, developer will surely port it. Or just even wait for the GSI port. Yeah, that would work too. Then again, going to the lock screen password, you have face data. Yes, it fully works. So let me just try that. Tap. Again, not bad at all. I have recorded the face data in extremely bad conditions, like there is a light shining through my head right now. Your full screen display for some odd weird reasons. Yeah, you can just enable it to use your gestures, and again, it works. Wow, it even disables the button. So yeah, you can just completely go buttonless. And then again, the MI1's body is just made like that. The buttons just disappear. Unlike the Redmi Note 4, you can still see the buttons on Note 4. On MI1, it just works good. Like literally look at this. It's just amazing. And yeah guys, that's pretty much it for MIUI 10 on MIA1. Now those who are still thinking this is a Mi 5X, here you go, Android 1. If you still think I have changed the back panel, I live in India. I can't afford to just import a Mi 5X for a single video. If you still think this is Mi 5X, you seriously need some help, and let's just get to the installation. So first of all, you will need to unlock your bootloader, no issue at all, as this is an Android 1 device, and you will need some of a bit brain in installing custom ROMs and a PC. So let's just move on. So now once you're on your PC, you will need these 6 files. But first of all, just go to your phone, go to about phone section, search for build number, tap on it several times. Once it shows developer options, go to developer options and enable OEM unlock. This will actually allow you to enable the bootloader unlock, and then just hold on your power and volume down at the same time. Let go and connect the phone to your PC. Then just go to the ADB folder that I have given, open CMD and type in Fastboot devices. There you go. If it shows the random number and fastboot, our device has been successfully connected, then type in fastboot OEM unlock, hit enter. Now this will unlock the actual bootloader of your phone. Now once that is done, just copy these two IMG files into the folder, just like this. Going to the CMD again, type in fastboot/userdata, again userdata.img. Now this is a internal storage data from Mi 5X running on Android Nougat. This will actually help the phone to just thinking that it's a Mi 5X. Once that is done, type in fastboot, then again drag it aside and select the TORP IMG. Now this won't actually install the TORP IMG, this is just to boot it. If you have just unlocked the bootloader, don't flash it, just boot it for the first time and hit enter. Now the phone will automatically boot into the TORP recovery. As you can see, the phone automatically went into the recovery, so never show this again, allow modifications. Then go to wipe, format data, type in yes. This is actually to remove encryption if you are running Android 8.1. Go home, go to wipe, advanced wipe, system data, and internal storage again, swipe to wipe. Our phone has been successfully decrypted. Go to home. Now as you can see, our internal storage is automatically over here. Now just copy these files, that would be the Epic ROM and the TORP installer, and also the MIUI 10 camera. Once all the files have been copied, just go to install and just first of all install the TORP installer, confirm to flash, done. Now reboot the recovery once in order to activate all the partitions, swipe to reboot. We are again into the recovery, swipe to allow modifications, go to install. Install the Epic ROM, confirm to flash. Now that the ROM has been installed, again swipe to unlock, reboot system, do not install. And congrats, you have successfully installed the much awaited MIUI 10 on your MIA1. The first boot will actually take around 10 minutes because it has to actually pass some of the security checks of MIUI 10. So the screen will actually blink a couple of times, but it's just okay. It's just Epic ROM doing its stuff. So I will just meet you guys after a few minutes. So the ROM has been finally booted, and that wasn't too long that I expected. So let's just complete the setup. So quickly, English, skip, next, and done, voila. Now as you can see, if you go to the camera, you have the stock MIUI 9 camera over here. So let's just change it to the MIUI 10 by going to the file manager, APKs, MIUI camera, enable the unknown sources, okay, install, open. And there you go, you have the full MIUI 10 camera working with the portrait mode. And yeah guys, that's pretty much it on how you install MIUI 10 on MI1. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you want more videos, such as I'm working on the AI camera for MI1 ported from Mi Max 3. If you want to see that soon, please let me know in the comment section below. Be sure to subscribe and see you in the next one. Peace.